Good to see all of you again. Now, what are we going to do? Today's lesson, finding all factors of a number. Right. And our example today is 64. How are we going to start this? Well, we're going to start with 1. So think now. 1 times what equals 64? 64, right. Next, we're going to try 2. 2 times what equals 64? Maybe better if we divide it. Two goes into 6, how many times? 2 times 3, right. Then we're going to multiply the 2 and 3. 2 times 3 equals 6. Subtract. Two goes into 4, how many times? 2 times, right. Okay, 2 times 2 is 4. We subtract. Okay, now, 2 times 32 equals 64. Notice that all the other factors are found where? Well, they're found between the 2 and the 32. Next, let's try 3. Let's see, 3 into 64, let's think about this. I don't know. Well, we can divide. Three goes into 6. How many times? 2 times. 2 times 3 equals 6. We can subtract. And then 3 goes into 4. How many times is that? Oh, 1 time. 3 times 1 equals 3. Now we subtract. 4 minus 3 is 1. Oh, we've got 1 remaining means we can't use 3. Darn it. Next, we're going to try 4. How many times does 4 go into 64? Let's see, 4 goes into 6 how many times? 4 times 1 equals 4. Now what do? Subtract. 6 subtract 4, that's going to be 2. Bring down the 4. 4 goes into 24. How many times? Let's see, 4 times 5 equals 20. 4 times 6 equals 24. Six times 4 equals 24. Now, what are we going to do? We're going to subtract. 24 minus 24, that's going to equal 0. That means that 4 times 16 equals 64.
Sorry, signing error. 4 times 16 equals 64. 4 times 16 doesn't equal 24. Now, back to the video.
All the other factors are found between 4 and 16. Next, we're going to try 5. How many times does 5 go into 64? Well, we can use the rule for dividing by 5. Suppose the last digit of a number is 5. Or 0. That means the number can be divisible by 5. For example, 70. The last digit is 0. That means you can divide that number by 5. 25. The last digit is 5. Well, that means that number can also be divisible by 5. Next, we're going to try 6. How many times does 6 go into 64? 6 goes into 6 once. 1 times 6 is 6. Now we're going to subtract. 6 minus 6 is 0. Bring down the 4. 6 goes into 4. It can't. Oh, that means we're going to have a remainder of 4. That means 6 can't be used. Dang it. Okay, but we can't give up. We got to continue on. We're almost finished. Now, we're going to try 7. How many times does 7 go into 64? Let's think. 7 times 2 equals 14. 7 times 3 equals 21. 7 times 9 equals 63. Now we're going to subtract 64 minus 63, and that equals 1. 1 is our remainder, means, well, we can't use 7. Shoot. Okay, well, we can't give up. We're almost finished. Next, we're going to try 8. How many times does 8 go into 64? Let's think on this. 8 times 3 equals 24, 8 times 4 equals 32, 8 times 7 equals 56, 8 times 8 equals 64, right. Remember, all the other factors are between 8 and 8 and 8. Oh, that means we're finished.
Okay, yeah, we're finished now. These are all factors of 64. We've got 1, 2, 4, 8, 8. Oh, I almost forgot. We don't have to write 8 twice. All right, now that we're done, I hope you enjoyed the video, and we will see you later, and good luck.